Welcome back to Penn State Sports Night. I'm your host, Anna Middleton. Alongside me is Jack Hirsh and Evan Lasek. And tonight, with Penn State's whiteout game against Michigan looming this upcoming Saturday, we'll be breaking down all aspects of the matchup. Penn State quarterback Sean Clifford had a shaky outing against Iowa last weekend, only completing 50% on his passes for 117 yards. He did add one touchdown in the 17-12 victory over the Hawkeyes, but is this a sign that things are coming for the sophomore?
I think people should not be concerned about Sean Clifford. No, he did not have the most impressive stat line. He didn't have the 300 yards. He didn't have the many touchdowns, but he got the job done. He made great decisions. He made great reads, and he performed well under the pressure. Yes, it was another slow first half start for him, but there were receivers that did not really perform. Iowa is a great defense, and people aren't giving them that. They're ranked for a reason, and Sean Clifford really showed out why he should be starting, and he's making Penn State fans excited, I believe. He's going to continue to prove his worth, I believe.
And I think the important thing to note there is that he's only thrown two interceptions all year. One of them was Saturday night, of course, but you know, he's really taken care of the ball really well. I really don't think Penn State fans should really be concerned about him of all things. There are other things to be concerned about, granted for a 6-0 team, but there's not really that much to be.
Yeah, I forgot to add in the 13 touchdowns and 2 interceptions. That's a great ratio, especially for a first-year starter in a very competitive division. He's just looking good.
Yeah.
All right, moving on to running backs. We have Journey Brown, Devin Ford, Noah Kane, and Ricky Slade all seeing action on the field this year so far. Noah Kane dominating with 2 weeks, 100-yard runs together. Now, what do you see with the running backs?
What I see with the running backs is that Ricky Slade is clearly getting too many carries. There was a drive in the second quarter where Noah Kane was doing really well, and for some reason Penn State subbed him out with Ricky Slade of all people. I don't even know why James Franklin chose to go to Ricky Slade. The point was not that Noah Kane came out, but the point was that Ricky Slade came in. Ricky Slade has been averaging 2.1 yards rushing per carry. That's not going to get it done in the Big Ten. So where I think they really need to go is Noah Kane has really come out as the guy in this you know, backfield of four starters. Against Iowa in the first quarter, he had runs of 7, 7, 5, 5, 3, 4, 4. That's consistency. He's consistently falling forward. You know what you notice about those carry numbers? There was not a single negative play in that. So obviously, now the wild thing is, he was taken out in that one drive in the second quarter. He didn't play in the third quarter. Like, it's just, I understand Penn State has four really talented running backs. One of them has not done really well. Three Penn State running backs so far this year have had 100-yard games. The one that hasn't is Ricky Slade. Devin Ford, Journey Brown have had really good seasons so far. They're averaging above 6.5 yards a carry, but most of their yardage came on one run each. Both had an 80-plus-yard run. For Ford, it came in the Idaho game, and for Journey Brown, it came in the pick game. So I really think it's time for Penn State to move on and say, Noah Kane, you are the feature back.
Yeah, in the NFL, you see all these running back by committees, and I think that's what Penn State was trying. They had good backs, but now they just need to stick with Noah Kane. He's averaging great numbers. He's 2 consecutive 100-yard games. Ricky Slade is still the starter in Penn State. He, last game against Iowa, he had 4 rushes for 8 yards. He negative plays, but Noah Kane just continues to run up the middle. As you said, he continues to get positive yards. If they keep running up the middle, their run block looks beautiful. Even when they bounce it outside and do that option pitch play, that was killing Iowa, and I think that's going to continue to succeed.
And that pitch play was the one that Noah Kane scored on late in the game, and he had 67 yards in the fourth quarter alone to really eat the clock and help the Nittany Lions pull away in that win.
All right, Noah Kane has been dominating on the field so far. The Nittany Lions record is 6-0 so far. What do you think they have to improve on getting into the meat of their season?
The biggest problem that Penn State fans have seen is the secondary. They've been they've been picked apart on the long ball all season. They're just not looking up. They're not tracking the ball. They're letting the guy fly right past them. And when they don't, it's defensive penalties, defensive holding that just continues drives. And these third and longs with John Reed holding or Tariq just holding the receiver as they try to fly past, it's not helping the defense. And they need to improve on that, or big teams like Ohio State that they play later in the year, that's just going to hurt them in the long run. And you can't take those negative plays and continue the long drives.
I see your problems with the secondary, but Penn State has only given up 200 yards passing per game. Obviously, the pick quarterback had a really good game, and you know, Nate Stanley the other night had a really good game against them as well. But where I see the problem is, you know, Penn State has these awesome special teams weapons. And you know, you say, oh, special teams, that's not really that sexy to talk about special teams. But you know, they have these weapons like Blake Gillikin, KJ Hamler. Blake Gillikin is having a decent season for his own name. He's averaging just over 40 yards a punt, which is, you know, kind of okay. You could see that number get a little bit better, but the real issue here is on kick return. Penn State is constantly starting out with negative kick returns and not making it to the 25. KJ Hamler is just averaging about 14 yards a kickoff. I mean, KJ Hamler is one of the most electric guys in college football, and he's barely making it past the 20.
Yeah, I believe the frustrating part is you see this explosive KJ Hamler who has blazing speed and he can't really get past the 20. He may as well just take the touchback or call the fair catch and take the ball to 25, because at this point it is hurting his team and it's just not beneficial to him to keep returning these kicks. You see all these other teams, they're calling fair catches, they're getting the ball to 25.
Yeah, seriously, decision making needs to be a key point in practice moving forward.
All right, moving forward onto what some people say the best atmosphere in college football, the whiteout game. What do you think Michigan will have to do to win the whiteout game?
Michigan's going to need to really practice their non-vocal play calling because it's loud there. There's going to be a lot of miscues. There are going to be a lot of bad routes. Shea Patterson's not going to look good. He hasn't looked good all season. I don't think he'll be able to handle the pressure, honestly, because that is a very tough play. They're going to be getting in his head, and it's just going to make him make mistakes.
You know, the spread opened up for this game at 4.5, or opened up at 3.5. It's now 4.5. I'm saying that's free money for Penn State fans if you want to take Penn State to cover the spread. This happened 2 years ago where Michigan had one loss. They were highly ranked going into the season, had one loss coming in, and Penn State just dominated them 42-13. I kind of see that playing out again, honestly.
Yeah, even with the loss last year in the whiteout, Ohio State was still held to 28, and they were a high-scoring offense. That whiteout, it definitely gets to opposing teams. It does not make it easy on them.
Penn State's defensive line pass rush is as good as I've ever seen it.
Let's not get too far ahead of this week, but how do you see the rest of the Nittany Lions season turning out?
You got to take it 1 week at a time, of course. You can't be looking ahead to playoffs or bowl games. You need to win each week. You need to go into practice. You need to win that practice. You need to go in the game. You need to win the game. Each week, you got to get better at something. The drops killed us early in the first half. They got a hang on it, and then they just started looking better. The offense started rolling plays. Drives kept alive, and then you just need to go into this Michigan game, come out, and then work on what you learned, what you saw from that game.
You know, obviously James Franklin doesn't want us to get ahead, so we're thinking Michigan, Michigan, Michigan. But, you know, as a reporter, I'm not part of the team. So, you know what, I'm going to look ahead. Michigan State, not that big of a deal. Move on to Minnesota, Minnesota, Minnesota. That is Penn State's Super Bowl. Obviously, Minnesota hasn't played that many great teams. Penn State seemingly will have two ranked wins going into that game. But, you know, Minnesota's going to be 8-0. They're going to be rolling. They're going to be really, really hot. You know, I think Minnesota, and then obviously Ohio State on November 23rd, a game that I'm fortunate enough to get to go to this year, which will be really cool. But those two games are going to decide if Penn State is going to be playing for a college football playoff berth or not.
Very true. The whiteout game against Michigan will kick off at 7:30 p.m. this Saturday in Beaver Stadium. That's all we have for Penn State Sports Night. For Jack Hirsh, Evan Lasek, I'm Anna Middleton. Have a great night.
Thank you for watching our latest edition of Penn State Sports Night. If you're a fan of our content, please be sure to subscribe to our YouTube channel for more clips. Also follow us on Twitter at PSSNTV and on Instagram at PSU Sports Night to keep up with the action. For all my colleagues, we are Penn State Sports Night.